Hey, welcome to Catholic Breakfast. Father John Muir alongside Father Matt Lowry, chaplain of the Newman Center at Northern Arizona University in Flagstaff, Arizona. Father Matt, welcome.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Today we're going to talk about advice for parents of Catholic University students. First, I just want to thank our university students who are here in our live studio audience. How are you guys doing today? Thank you. You know, we're going to ask Father Matt about what advice he has for parents of Catholic University students, but why don't you tell me a few things? If you could give Catholic parents advice, what would you say?
Don't show up without telling me you're coming.
Don't show up without telling me you're coming. So Catholic parents, take note of that. How about one more?
What do you need?
Yeah, what do you need?
Money.
Send money.
Send money.
Yeah. Anywho, let's ask Father Matt, what advice would you give Catholic parents, especially with maybe parents who just feel like, my kids are going into this hostile environment where the Catholic faith is going to get like beaten out of you. What can Catholic parents do to help their students grow in the maturity of faith? And
while
you give your answer, I'm going to beat you at pool.
Please. I think the first thing is the parents' own witness, being joyful, having a personal relationship with the Lord, that college students, they're looking for what's genuine, and they can spot what's fake.
But now, why do you say that? Because, I mean, the students are at college, the parents are at home. So how do you see that like affecting the college students?
You can spot genuineness. And so even far away, I think your prayerful witness, your sacrifices, fasting, the way that you talk about the faith, it says a lot.
As you say that, I remember, even though I was in a totally different state, I was all of a sudden getting curious, like, How do my parents live the Catholic faith? Because I realized it's not automatic all of a sudden. I was like, oh, not everybody has faith in Christ, faith in God. So my radar was up every time I would talk to them in a new way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do think there's other things too. When you come and visit, even to check out the campus, find out where the Newman Center is, or the Catholic Center, meet some people, and that can make a good first impression. Because when you actually meet some people and they know you, and they know your name and recognize you, or when you come to visit, you can go to Mass and then go to breakfast. And so even if the student doesn't normally go to Mass, you know, like, we're gonna come see you and then we're gonna go grab some breakfast.
Totally. Just like the way you'd help your student like figure out, oh, hey, the library's over there, the cafeteria's over there, the Catholic chapel's over there.
I think also you kind of show them like...
Nice shot.
Thank you. There are some benefits to being a college chaplain. So... That was pretty good.
That was good.
I think the other thing too is being able to talk about their faith and not be shut down, you know? So students start to feel like, I disagree with what the church teaches on X. And to be able to do that in a way that's genuine.
What about the whole, I think what a lot of parents kind of freak out about is, oh my gosh, my kid went to Catholic school, or we invested all this time and energy into their Catholic faith, and he's not going to church.
Yeah.
She's not going to church. And then the reaction is, I am going to nag you until you, quote, go to church. You know, like, what would you say to the parents who maybe do that?
I say, how does that work for you? Not well, right?
Yeah.
That people want freedom. What I think of is the story of the prodigal son, Luke 15, where we think about how the father welcomes the son back. But in order to do that, he first had to let him walk away. And when the son comes back, there's no bitterness, there's no anger, there's just pure acceptance. And so I think young people are asking themselves, they're asking their parents, will you still love me if I don't do what you want me to do? Do you only love me because I'm doing what you're saying?
Yeah.
And so you kind of stretch your legs a little bit, but if the seeds are planted, like Fulton Sheen used to say, if you give me a child till he's what, you know, 14, he'll be a Catholic for life, you know? And so I think we have to love them and express how we feel. Like, you know, it hurts me. I feel disappointed that you're not going to Mass. You don't have to go to Mass. And even if you never went to Mass again the rest of your life, I will never stop loving you. But I want you to be happy. And that's why I want this for you. But I want you to want it.
Yeah, that's good. Because the point is, like, the whole reason, like, the Catholic faith is about the happiness and the perfection of the human person. Yeah, so it definitely doesn't work in college to keep going to, you know.
The pressure doesn't
work. I go because my parents want me to go. That just doesn't work.
God knows that we need freedom to open up so that His grace can come in and work.
Yeah, yeah. Well, in terms of help, how can parents pray for their college students as a way to support them?
One thing to do is you, as you go to like adoration or in the chapel, I love this image of just like putting your son or daughter before on the altar before the Lord. You could also, you know, maybe in the arms of Mary. And so like literally kind of feeling like a letting go of like, God loves my son or daughter more than I do. I can let go. It doesn't mean I don't care. It actually means I trust and I do care.
Yeah, that's good. So you, a parent might physically let their kid go to college, but are they like, that kind of prayer is a kind of a spiritual, I am spiritually entrusting my child into God's hands.
And,
yeah.
And that's where it comes in. If they're continuing to grow in their own faith, the child's going to see that. All of a sudden, we've had students come here and their parents start doing Bible study back home and they're like, that's weird.
You know? Yeah, like, yeah.
But they see it.
Right.
And it makes an impression like they're living their faith. Maybe I should.
Yeah, that's good, because it's not like the parents' faith is static and they want the child's faith to keep growing. Our faith is always growing, right? Because they're growing together in the different stages of their life. Well, that's great advice. So it's praying for them. It's practical ways to support them. But then thirdly, praying for them, yeah. And growing in their faith too. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Father Matt.
You're welcome.